जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने।
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने, हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने।
जीवन ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने। कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े, वे विषय के लोच से युक्त हो।
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े, वे विषय के लोच से युक्त हो।
मित्रों हम उठे और जागे, ये प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने।
Welcome to the discipline of sociology. Dear learners, I am Sukant Kumar Mahapatra, Academy Officer Sociology. I welcome all of you on behalf of NIOS. It is a great pleasure to know that you have chosen sociology as one of your subjects, which has a great relevance in the era of globalization. Today we have with us Professor Tulsi Patel, who is from Delhi School of Economics, University of Delhi. She is a leading sociologist and has more than 30 years of experiences teaching sociology in University of Delhi. Welcome to Professor Tulsi Patel. Today we'll discuss about what sociology is, the meaning and definition of sociology. I invite Professor Tulsi Patel to discuss again on the subject sociology and introduction.
Dear learners, it is a pleasure to speak with you about what is the meaning of sociology. When people say, define sociology, or what do you understand by sociology, we have to think of what does it mean when we say we are studying sociology? Sociology is a discipline that studies social relations. Like other disciplines or subjects in the open school, economics, history, civics, sociology is also one subject. When we say it studies human relations in society, what are these human relations? To take one example, as a child, when in the morning your mother or your father wake you up to get ready for school, maybe one of them takes you to the bus stop, or your grandfather or grandmother takes you to the bus stop. When you reach the bus stop, there are other students like you. You greet them. Your grandfather or grandmother greets other adults and other children who are waiting for the school bus. At a certain time, the bus arrives. The conductor makes sure that children get into the bus. And once the children are on the bus, people who have come to see them off say goodbye or see you, and then the children are in the bus. Once they are settled, the bus driver drives the bus to another stop to pick up more students to be able to reach school on time. Now, in this example, if you try and see what are human relations in society, the human relations in this example are those activities where you are interacting with others. If you ask the question, where are you acting as a single, alone individual, it will be possible for you to say that I woke up, I got ready, I went to the bus stop, I got onto the bus. But if you consider who woke you up, who got you ready, with whom did you walk to the bus stop, how did the conductor and the driver take you on the bus, how the driver reached you to the school on time, you would realize that for most of these activities in our example, you have been behaving in a context where you were with some or the other person. And this kind of activity where you are interacting with some other person in society, that certain social relations are established. These social relations are in some way the subject matter of sociology, but they are not to be treated as stray examples. In sociology, you study human associations and relations in such a way that in this very example, let us see how you are connected with people in the family, people in the neighborhood, people who are your friends, with the school, with the traffic system, with the transport system, where the bus and the driver take you to school. So at one level, you are immediately related to your parents, at another level with your grandparents, then with your friends, then with the driver and the conductor, then with the school system, your teachers, principal, other students in the school. So in one example itself, you see so many sets of social relations and other people with whom you are interacting. This kind of interactive behavior forms certain patterns, and the study of those patterns of relationships is what we primarily understand and try to study in sociology. That constitutes the subject matter of sociology. Like in this picture, we see that an individual is part of the family, part of the education system, the media reports about it, there is the transportation system, there is law, there is religion, there is education. All these institutions in society are there, and human beings interact with other human beings in these contexts, be it the context of family, marriage, school, transport, law, religion, etc. So these sets of relationships make the subject matter of sociology. Now, in this very example, if we see how social relations are established, there is one factor, and that is the factor of time, that we can understand how that factor of time is important for so many people. You get up on time, you get ready on time so that you can reach the bus stop on time. The bus will arrive at a certain time and take you to school at a certain fixed time. How do you coordinate your behavior and your activities in such a way so that other people's time is kept in mind by you, by your parents, by your grandfather or grandmother, by the bus conductor and also by the school? How do we manage to see that our behavior and our activities are coordinated in such a way that we all manage to do things according to the time given to us and we accept the time that others expect us to do our activities? This kind of time schedule which we try to coordinate with others is because when our parents wake us up and they get us ready to go to school and the school expects us to reach on time, it is because all these people who are concerned with waking us up, sending us to school, reaching us to school on time are actually agreeing. They share the value of time and they share the value of schooling. They think that going to school is a good activity for society. Students, after they finish schooling or after they have finished education, will work for the society and the society's life will carry forward. Now, there are in this practice certain norms and rules which we value. When we value these norms and rules, we follow these norms and rules because we consider them as good. Those who do not follow these norms and rules are in some way not considered or their behavior is not approved. So their activities are criticized or in some way punished. So it is not that somebody is constantly telling us about what to do all the time, but if we see how in this example we come to understand that getting up on time is good, getting to school on time is good, we begin to say that we share values and norms. The sharing of values and norms is something which then becomes an accepted form of human interaction and human behavior for members of the society. Whether one is acting only as an individual, how does that acting take place as a socially valued behavior? It is because if we take the example of the French sociologist Émile Durkheim, he had given one example which we can use in another context here, and the context is that we will be following traffic rules even when there is no policeman. How does the traffic rule get followed by us in the absence of the policeman? Because when we see a traffic signal, we follow the traffic signal's indications because we know that organized traffic allows us to avoid accidents. Organized traffic allows us for a smooth flow and the possibility to reach our destination on time. This is possible because we value time and because we value the safety of others and our own safety on the roads. So, public transport has certain values and we have a certain understanding about the rules of that transport and we begin to value the rules of the transport and therefore we follow the practice of following traffic signals. There are many people who are not able to go to school on time. There are many people who have to drop out of school after class 9, 10 or 11. They look for jobs without completing the school and sometimes it so happens not because they have not worked hard but because their parents do not have money to send them to school. In that context, there is a possibility of coming to the National Open School and doing sociology or any other subject of your choice. But if you work hard and you are told that by hard work and good schooling, you will get a job. Yes, but what is important to keep in mind is that jobs are not automatically available after completing school, which means that hard work which an individual is doing when the individual is going to school and studying in a school is very important, but it is not the end of it. One individual is related to studies and to the job market. Sometimes your studies and job market may not match with each other. In that context, you need to improve your skills and explore what the job market is. To take one example, in the last 20 years, those students who were trained in software technology found a lot of scope of jobs both within India and also outside India. But if you see the last 2 or 3 years, the scope of those who studied software, the jobs for them are not coming at the same rate, both in the country and outside the country, which means a student as an individual and hard work of the student as an individual is one thing. But it is also important to see that human relationships are not only affected by one individual's hard work, but at the same time also about how the national and international economies are doing influence the possibility of jobs. And there is competition in jobs. People are competing and cooperating at different levels. This kind of competition and cooperation takes place in society, and you can see that the possibility of having jobs also depends on the kind of economic up movement or down movement in different economies. In Europe and the US, these days the economies are not doing well, and that is influencing the job market of software engineers and software specialists. So getting a good training in school is important, but there is also the larger global national economy that is related with the kind of jobs and the possibility of jobs people will have. There is also the difficulty of understanding how national and international policies influence people's lives, and it is in this light that we see how we are concerned and connected with other people and other people's decisions, and an individual is not alone. The relationship of one person with another and sets of relationships in this manner constitute the subject matter of sociology, and it is this kind of subject matter that we consider sociology. And if you try and see these examples of jobs, how people study and look for jobs and get jobs, and how the family raises children and sees to it that they value and keep time and work hard according to the time that society honors, both are correlated, both have a certain relationship with each other, and the chances of somebody doing well in studies and also getting a good job may have a positive relation, and it is in this light that we see patterns emerging between education as a system, hard work by students, and jobs that are possible to get. These patterns are studied by sociologists, and this is constituting one set of subject matter. Sociology could study family as an institution, marriage practices, educational practices, transport practices, legal practices, etc. This pattern of studying the subject matter of sociology is what sociology is made of. And it is in this light that we can go back to what is the meaning of sociology, particularly the definition of sociology.
Madam, you told to our learners that individuals do a lot of actions. Can you tell to our learners how do their actions relate to other individuals?
Yes, we can talk about how individual activities are correlated and coordinated with others in society. The act of waking up is an act of an individual, but you wake up because your parents think that it is important for you to wake up before going to school. You have to be able to get ready, reach the bus stop, get onto the bus and reach the school on time. This activity is individual at one level, but because you are being woken up, you are walking to the bus stop with your grandparents, you are with other students in the bus, you are interacting with other students, the driver and conductor are looking after the safety of the students when they take them to the school, are all coordinated activities. In this way, the activities are coordinated directly with people with whom you are in interaction, but also indirectly with the transport system, the rules of transport, and with the educational system in this very example, and with the rules and norms and values of the family.
Can you say something more about coordination of human activities to understand sociology?
Yeah, one thing which is very important for us to understand in sociology is that human activities are coordinated with those of the activities of others in society for the smooth functioning of the society. You could also go back to your class 6 and 7 studies and ask me that, ma'am, we had studied about the life of elephants, the life of ants, the life of honeybees. Their activities are also coordinated with the activities of other and their life also functions smoothly. So what is so unique about the interaction, social interaction of people in society, of human beings in society? Now, in this context, sociology becomes important and it covers only coordinated activities of human beings that form social relations among them, because you may go and study honeybees in Karnataka, Rajasthan or Kenya, but these activities are generally the same for honeybees. But if you go to different parts of the world or different states in India, for instance, a Tamilian is different from a Gujarati, a Malayali is different from a Bengali, a Punjabi is different from a Kashmiri. Now, these people have different cultural characteristics and traits, their human relations are different. So, in that sense, we cannot say that the pattern of relations and the coordination of these relations among human beings is the same as among honeybees or elephants. And that is what makes the subject matter of sociology very unique, because the coordination of activities and the formation of social relations, be they the relations of family, marriage, etc., or practices of art, law, custom, tradition, they differ from one culture to another, be it in the US or Germany or India. And this kind of cultural variation also shows how human relations vary among people. So it is in this light we can see how tribals are different from other communities.
Ma'am, can you say about the term sociology to our learners?
Yes, the term sociology is constituted of two words. One is socius, which is an old European language, and logos, which is the Greek word, and it means two words are put together in constituting the term sociology. Socius means association or relation from Latin, and logos means pattern or theory. The pattern or theory of social relations or human associations is what constitutes sociology, and that is what the meaning of sociology. So it comes from these two words, and the engineer turned sociologist, this French scholar called Auguste Comte, is known as the father of sociology, who is attributed the term sociology to.
Madam, can you tell some definitions about sociology to our learners?
Yes, for definitions they come from different scholars, and we can use one PowerPoint presentation for seeing the definitions that come from Auguste Comte, Max Weber, Durkheim, who have talked about what sociology is and how it is defined. Comparing the definitions and also taking the examples that we have discussed, now we get some idea of what the subject matter of sociology is, which means what sociology does. And because a discipline is known from or known through what it does, we are able to understand what is the meaning of sociology. So if your brother or sister or somebody known to you but who does not know sociology asks you what is sociology and what it does, I am hopeful you will be able to explain what sociology is.
Thank you, madam, for your sharing your enriching experience and expertise with our learners. Hope our learners have got a sufficient exposure to the concept of sociology, meaning and its definitions. Hope you will be able to understand the meaning and concept, and will also give your feedback to us so that we can improve our study material for sociology. Thank you, learners.
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने
पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय के